How's it going, friends? Craig Power with Power Realty Advisors, serving Greater Boston and the South Shore. And today I am showing you how to write an offer in the state of Massachusetts. We're gonna be taking a close look at the standard forms given to me by the real estate board in Massachusetts. And I feel like this could be good information really for anybody, even if you're not looking to buy a home in the immediate future, right? Could be good knowledge for later. So if you wanna come back to it, you know, as the kids say, smash that subscribe button, and you know, don't hesitate to insult me in the comments either. Really get after it. So no, I really do feel like this could be good information for later. I remember before I got into real estate thinking, like, you know, making an offer on a house, how does that work? Do I just march into an open house, I shake the agent's hand, I give him my price, and that's the deal? What is it to make an offer? I'm gonna show you up close a form called an offer to purchase real estate. It's a single page document. And then I'm gonna follow that up with another single page form called a three-part contingency addendum. That is used pretty commonly in the state of Massachusetts. And that has more to do with like your home inspection contingency and so forth. So as we go along, I may pause a couple times just to talk about offer strategy, how to get the deal on your terms, edging out the competition, really how to get the deal accepted in the first place. So when you're writing up an offer, the main things you're looking to tell the seller are purchase price, right? How much you're offering. You're telling them how you're going to pay for it, whether that means cash or financing. Scheduling, right? When's the closing date? All that. Earnest money and down payment amounts. And then contingencies, like your home inspection contingency, for example. So let's dive right in. Let's start at the top. Okay, here's the offer to purchase real estate. This is the Greater Boston Real Estate Board form. In Massachusetts, there's another version of the written offer you might see. I think this one is just simpler and easier to read, especially for our purposes here. So offer is to the current owner. Today's date from the Office of Power Realty Advisors. This is, of course, written as if I'm your buyer's agent. Property address, you know, the fictional address here, I'm just pulling this. And then it says the seller is being presented this offer from, again, fictional name for the seller's agent here is Agent Burt Macklin. And the buyer's agent here is Power Realty Advisors. So you can ignore all that, but moving on. I will pay, therefore, $500,000. This is total purchase price. Aiming to use round numbers here. So you are offering a total of $500,000 for this home. $1,000 earnest money is due as soon as the seller accepts the offer. That is part of the $500,000. The next deposit is made upon the signing of the purchase and sale agreement. Usually the intended goal is for the buyer to bring the transaction up to 4 or 5% down. You know, $24,000 plus $1,000 is $25,000, which is 5% of the total purchase price of $500,000 here. Okay, so I hope that makes sense. And then at closing, the remaining funds are due. This section is not super explicit about, you know, how much of these funds are cash versus how much will be in your loan. This section doesn't indicate that. It's just saying we will deliver the remainder at closing. All these should add up to the total purchase price again, and then we get into a few important dates. So first off, the expiration of the offer itself. When you make an offer on a home, you're making that offer today, but the seller can't just decide a year from now, hey, I accept your offer. Oftentimes, you will have a 24-hour expiration on an offer. Depends on the situation, right? You may try to be aggressive and say, hey, take it or leave it now in just a short time. This offer's only good for a little while. Or if your strategy is to play the heartstrings a little bit in this age of bidding wars, maybe you know you're not the highest offer, so you're playing with emotion. You're trying to look like an easy person to deal with. The opposite of the aggressive offer, you might say, hey, take your time, think this over, offer doesn't expire for a few days. That's what I would say. Next date is the purchase and sale. We'll talk about this more in the contingency addendum, because between the time you get your offer accepted and you sign the purchase and sale agreement, that is when your home inspection takes place. So this is a 13-day, two-week gap here. I'd say that's average. And then you have the closing date, which I have a little over a full month later here. This is a month after the signing of the purchase and sale. 6 to 7 weeks after offer acceptance. This is your pretty standard timeline, especially now. I understand a lot of mortgage underwriters with all the refinances, they've been a little backed up. So we've been hedging a little bit and stretching out the timeline. But yeah, I would say this is pretty standard. You know, you may want to know if the seller has a preferred closing date or timeline in mind. That would be something for your buyer's agent to ask. Maybe they're buying a new place, or maybe you want to say, you know, depending on your plans, hey, I'm trying to get in there as fast as possible, or, you know, I can't close for a longer time because of whatever reason. Next important section is about contingencies or additional terms of the deal. Since we are theoretically sending this offer in with an attached addendum, that's the only contingency I've included here. In other cases, though, this could be a lot. You know, for example, you could write in an appraisal contingency here, subject to property appraising at or above the offer price. You could say, buyer requests reasonable access for vendor quotes if you're going to be doing work to the place and you want to gather quotes and do some legwork for your construction project. That could be written here. Suitable housing contingencies, stuff like that. Beyond that, it's really just signatures here. You know, seller will sign if they accept your offer, and there's a receipt for the earnest money deposit attached. Your earnest money deposit will be held, you know, more than likely by the listing agent's brokerage. Okay, so that is an offer to purchase, and a little tip for you to remember as you're going forward, when it comes to contingencies and stuff, right, I'm recording this in January 2021 in the greater Boston real estate market where competition is fierce right now, and a big part of it is you want to deliver your offer the perfect way, and so what I would say is you want as little fine print as possible. Now, I'm not saying forego a home inspection contingency or appraisal contingency, anything like that. I'm not saying get rid of those contingencies. I'm saying you want them to be delivered in like a clean, clear, succinct little package. I think that really gives you the best chance of getting your offer accepted. And then, you know, your agent, right? This is where I wink at the camera. Your agent should also get on the phone with the seller's agent and really make a case for you and frame your offer the right way. So, you know, in my opinion, a good real estate agent does a lot of little things. And I think that's a big part of the job, especially with competition the way it is right now. But let's take a closer look at the addendum and go from there. In this sample offer, you're sending this with a three-part contingency addendum. Let's take a look here. So part one is the financing contingency, the mortgage contingency, and this is where we need to know how much are you putting down in total. Is it 3.5%? Is it 5%? Is it 10%? Is it 20%? Because we need to enter the amount of the loan you are applying for and pre-approve for. Also, the seller is gonna look at this. If they didn't know already, if it wasn't clear to them how much you were putting down, this is where they will sort of figure that number out. And generally, they will look at a buyer who is putting down more money as a more capable buyer. So all things being equal, right, they would prefer you putting more money down. The first date you're seeing here is the loan commitment date. Need to have your loan commitment from the lender by this date. At the end, we have your loan application deadline, meaning you need to submit a completed loan application by this time. Let's pause here. So when a seller accepts your offer, you have a signed offer. That offer is a call to action for both parties to deliver on their ends of the deal. So you have to get this loan application in by this date, or maybe even get it formally extended. In the event your financing falls through and you don't get approved for the loan later, and you didn't have your loan application submitted by this time, you risk losing your deposit. Okay, so like I said, it's a call to action for both parties. Listen, nothing like this has ever happened to me in my years of doing this, but that's important to know. And really what I'm stressing here is you, the buyer, are obligated to follow through on these parameters in this offer. Inspection is similar. Part two is the inspection contingency. In this sample offer, you're getting 10 days to conduct an inspection. You know, if we find in the aggregate X amount of repairs needed, I pretty much always say $1,000 here. If we find $1,000 worth of repairs needed, you have the option to back out of the deal. This can sometimes lead to renegotiation in some circumstances. Every house does have some stuff, but you need to revoke your offer back out by this date. Really, as soon as you get an offer accepted, don't wait until the last day to get your inspection. Get it done right away. Part three is pretty much the exact same thing except for pests and wood destroying insects. Same dates, same parameters. And then all parties sign here as well as the offer once it's accepted. Those are the documents. When we are actually submitting your offer these days, well, first off, everything is done electronically nowadays. We use a program called DocuSign for electronic signatures. So that makes things nice and quick and easy. You'd be surprised how quickly you can actually make an offer. But beyond that, you know, when we're sending it in to the seller's agent, we want to include, you know, your offer, your contingency addendum. We want to include any pre-approval letters from any lenders. We want to include maybe proof of funds, ideally a personalized letter from you to the seller, just something generic, but putting a face to the name and helping to massage that deal through. As I mentioned, I'm recording this in January of 2021, and the tough part of this process for buyers right now is the quick trigger finger required to put all this together. I mean, this is such a huge purchase, especially for first-time buyers, and the market moves so fast. There is this market pressure. It can feel like a whirlwind when you're in it. It's overwhelming, and so I feel like it's beneficial to, you know, get a grip on this information. I think it's beneficial to get a feel for making an offer long before you're actually making one, because as we know around here, right, again, it moves so fast, and you're often writing these offers trying to meet some deadline, you know, offers in by 5 p.m. Monday. And this is an emotional process, you know, you gotta work through it a little bit. I know we try to make it as stress-free as possible, but we're also responsible, you know, for giving this information. You know, I find myself just barraging my clients with, it's like information overload sometimes, some of these details, and it's a lot to squeeze in to a short amount of time. And the funny thing is I've had clients who make 5 or 6 offers before they even get one accepted, and by the third one, they're like, okay, yeah, sign here, initial here, you know, whatever, we fly right through it. That's today's lesson on writing an offer on a home in the state of Massachusetts. We are turning our YouTube channel into a little mini first-time homebuyer course. So, you know, as self-conscious as I feel asking you to subscribe, I hope you consider doing so, subscribing to the page. You know, we're also on Facebook or Instagram, Power Realty Advisors. You can find us. I think we have a lot of cool stuff coming your way in 2021. So yeah, like I said, I hope you follow along. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at the next one.